As I mentioned in the introduction to the previous tutorial, there are two importantly different ways in which an argument can satisfy the logic condition. One way is if the argument is valid. Another way is if the argument is strong. We've talked about validity, now let's talk about strength. Here's an argument. All humans have DNA, the molecule that carries the genetic information that you inherit from your parents. Pat is human, therefore Pat has DNA. This is a valid argument. If the premises are true, the conclusion can't possibly be false. Now take a look at this argument. 50% of humans are female. Pat is human, therefore Pat is female. That percentage isn't exact, but we're not interested in hearing whether the premises are actually true. We're interested in whether, if they were true, the conclusion would follow. In this case, the answer is clearly no. Knowing that Pat is human doesn't give us any good reason to think that he or she is female. This is an example of an argument that does not satisfy the logic condition. Now take a look at this argument. 90% of humans are right-handed. Pat is human, therefore Pat is right-handed. This argument is different. In this case, the premises make it very likely, 90% likely, that the conclusion is true. They don't guarantee that Pat is right-handed, but we might still want to say that they provide good reasons to think that Pat is right-handed. And if that's the case, then we should say that this argument satisfies the logic condition. Because it has the property that if all the premises are true, then they give us good reason to believe the conclusion. This difference is what the distinction between weak and strong arguments amounts to. The argument on the left is what we call a logically weak argument. It does not satisfy the logic condition, and so it can't be a good argument. The argument on the right is a logically strong argument. It does satisfy the logic condition, so it can be a good argument. This is what distinguishes these two arguments, but note what they have in common. They're both logically invalid. In a valid argument, if the premises are true, the conclusion can't possibly be false. But neither of these arguments guarantees certainty. They're both fallible inferences. Even if the premises are true, you could still be wrong about the conclusion. But the difference is that in a strong argument, the premises make the conclusion very likely to be true. Weak argument doesn't even give us this. Now, these examples immediately raise an important question. How strong does the inference have to be for the argument to satisfy the logic condition and qualify as a strong argument? Or put another way, with what probability must the conclusion have to follow from the premises for the argument to qualify as strong? 50% is clearly too weak. 90% is clearly strong enough. But where's the cutoff? What's the threshold that the strength of the logical inference has to meet to count as satisfying the logic condition? Well, it turns out that there is no principled answer to this question. The distinction between valid and invalid arguments is a sharp one. Every argument is either valid or invalid. There are no degrees of validity. Validity is like pregnancy. You can't be almost pregnant or a little bit pregnant. The distinction between strong and weak arguments, on the other hand, is a matter of degree. It does make sense to say that an argument is very strong, or moderately weak, or very weak. But the threshold between weak and strong arguments isn't fixed or specified by logic. It is, in fact, a conventional choice that we make. We decide when the premises provide sufficient evidence or reason to justify accepting the conclusion. There are no formal principles of logic that make this decision for us. This is actually a big topic. It needs a lot more space to properly discuss. And it really belongs in a course on inductive and scientific reasoning. But there are some common argument forms that people generally recognize as valid, strong, or weak that are helpful to know. Here are some simple argument forms that are recognized as valid, strong, and weak, respectively. The forms are identical, except for the highlighted words, all A or B, most A or B, almost all A or B, some A or B. An example of a valid argument of this form is all actors are robots. Tom is an actor, therefore Tom is a robot. We've seen this one before. But if we change all to most, we get an invalid but strong argument. Most actors are robots. Tom is an actor, therefore Tom is a robot. The conclusion doesn't follow with certainty, but we're stipulating here that most means enough to make it reasonable to believe the conclusion. And if we switch from most to some, like so, we get a weak argument. Some actors are robots doesn't even guarantee 50-50 odds. Some just means at least one actor is a robot. Now, these definitions summarize what we've seen so far. Validity, strength, and weakness are logical properties of arguments. They characterize the logical relationship between the premises and the conclusion. With valid arguments, the conclusion follows with certainty. It's impossible for the premises to be true and the conclusion false. With strong arguments, it's possible for the conclusion to be false, but it's unlikely. The conclusion follows with high probability. With weak arguments, the conclusion isn't even likely or highly probable. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's unlikely either, or that the conclusion has very low probability of being true. It just means that the premises don't give us good enough reason to think the conclusion is true. And finally, both valid and strong arguments satisfy the logic condition for an argument to be good. Weak arguments fail to satisfy the logic condition, and so are automatically ruled out as bad.